You probably heard this a million times already if you're in the market for a new home. Every real estate agent tells you pretty quickly, if you want to start looking at homes with me, you first need to get approved by a lender. On its face, this is true. As an agent, I need to know that your finances are in order before we begin looking at properties. There's no point in looking at homes you can't afford, and no point at all if no one is willing to give you a loan. So save yourself the time and potential disappointment by figuring this out up front. Plus, an approval helps you place a compelling offer on that wonderful home you find more quickly, making it more likely that it will be accepted. No seller wants to get an offer from someone who hasn't been approved, because it means you, the buyer, have no idea if any lender will provide you a mortgage or for how much. And that's a risk no seller wants to take. That being said, there are actually three different types of approvals you can get. Let me describe them for you. The first and weakest is called a pre-qualification. This is based on stated income that is not verified, so it's the least useful. And all other things being equal with competing offers, every listing agent will advise their client that this pre-qualification is worthless. The only thing worse is not having an approval letter at all. The second and most popular is an actual pre-approval. This is based on a lender verifying actual documents that paint a financial picture of your buying power. The lender can then give you a specific mortgage amount for which you're approved and a better idea of the interest rate. But it's not actually approved until it goes through underwriting. You're only halfway there. Some lenders will actually put the contract price on your letter so that if you're approved for more, the seller doesn't see this. It's none of their business. And by seeing it, it reduces your leverage when negotiating. I just did this with a buyer whose letter said she was approved for $450,000, but she offered only $445,000. Guess what? That letter pretty much tells me she can afford to pay $450,000, and she did. The final and strongest type of approval is an underwritten approval, which basically means you are 100% personally underwritten. At that point, when you sign a contract on a property, you just need inspections, title, and insurance, and you're basically good to go. Not only does this paint a rock-solid financial picture of you, it can mean the closing process is much faster. Why? Because instead of asking for a 21-day financing contingency to process your loan, your lender probably needs only 10 to 14 days. And sellers love this, because they only need to worry about your loan approval for 1 to 2 weeks instead of 3. Sure, this takes a little bit more time up front, but in a crazy competitive market, it can make your offer stand out as the most attractive. An easy way to remember these from weakest to strongest is the first letter of each, or QAU. Think of the three words quickest, approved, and underwritten. If you want the opportunity to put down a speedy offer on a house, getting underwritten approval is the best route, unless you plan to put down an all-cash offer. In that case, cash is king. And if you don't have cash, there are now companies that will buy your new home for you with cash and then sell it back to you later. But that's the subject of another video. Are you looking to get approved prior to making an offer? Shoot me a message and let's chat. Thanks for listening.